Hello everyone and welcome. In the last tutorial, we have learned about Spring repository. Now in this tutorial, we will dive into the world of Spring service. We'll explore what is Spring service, why you need them, and what is the benefit of using service annotation in our Spring Boot application. So let's dive into service. In Spring Boot, service is a component that contains all the business logic of our application. And it works as an intermediary between controller and repository layers. So when we receive a request in our server and we need to implement some business logic, we'll do that in the service layer, and all the related repository call will be done from the service. So a controller which receives a request from the server will just receive the request and pass the request to service. Service will process them. And when we need anything from database or we need to persist anything to database, we'll use repository. Okay. This is the layered architecture of a typical Spring Boot application. And the main idea of using service is to separate the business logic. So if you want to directly call the repository from controller, you can do that, but that is not the best approach to develop a professional application. Because when you use a separate service layer for your business logic, you actually separating the business concern, and this will provide you better maintainability and better organization of your code. And you can test the service separately, you can reuse the service in other part of the application if you need that. So this way, using a separate service for our business logics, we are having several benefits like reusability, abstraction, testability, flexibility, and separation of concern. So considering all those things, a service layer is crucial in an application. Now let's dive into coding. Here is our repository for our song entity, and we have created an entity package, a repository package. Now we will create a new package called service, which will hold all the business logic of our application. So here, for now, let's create a new service called song service. Okay. So for this service, we have to annotate it with @service. Here in our song service, we want to have all the songs by given artist and year. So I have written a method in our song service called getSongsByArtistAndYear. And this will now call the repository to fetch all the songs which have the given artist name and year. So how we can call the repository here? We have to create an object of the repository. The name of the repository is song repository. But song repository is an interface which will be implemented in the runtime. So what we'll do is we'll inject the dependency here with the annotation called AutoAdd. I will explain this in details in the following tutorial. For now, let's say we are annotating with it AutoAdd and creating an object of song repository and making it private. So this is called field injection. Another way of doing this is to annotate the constructor with parameter of this and annotating the constructor with this AutoAdd. So for now, let's call our song repository instance and call the method we have written for this, which is find songs by artist and year. So here the first parameter is artist name, second one is year, and that's all. In our service, we have written a method. Sorry, we have to return this. So this is how a service looks like for this example. Now we can call this get songs by artist and year from any controller or any other service, and this will return this, a list of song with the given criteria. I hope you have understand the basic idea of Spring service. If you have any question, you can always write your comment on below. I'll be happy to answer. I'll see you in the next tutorial.